SEAPLEX is the Scripps Environmental Accumulation of Plastics Expedition, which is a cruise written and designed and executed all by Scripps graduate students, which is made possible by a really cool program that we have here at Scripps called the UC Ship Funds, where people early in their career are able to apply to this fund competitively with their own proposals to get their own ship time, which is, it's pretty unusual, and we're really lucky to have it. On the SEAPLEX cruise, we're going to be trying to figure out the worst case scenario of the amount of plastics in the North Pacific Gyre. So, we don't have time to actually sample the entire North Pacific from Japan to California, which is where the gyre is. So we're going to be targeting some areas of high plastic accumulation out northeast of Hawaii, about 1,500 miles from shore. So we will be looking for where the plastic is, where is it in the water column in about the first 100 meters of water, and we'll be looking at what animals are found in proximity to the plastic. And we're mostly focusing on the little things at the base of the food chain. So we'll be looking at phytoplankton, the little plants, zooplankton, small fish, and fowling communities, which are the animals that grow directly attached to the plastic, like barnacles. So our goal is, again, to figure out what the baseline for this problem might be, just to start studying it in a rigorous way. Well, what's known is that there's definitely plastic out there. The Agulita Marine Research Foundation were the first people to research this problem. They've been going out there for about 10 years and showing that there is plastic out there and that there is some data that suggests it might be increasing. We definitely know there's stuff out there, but we really don't know what the extent is, what the size is. It's thought that 80% of the particles are really, really small, so you can't see them with your eyes. They're probably less than a couple millimeters, so maybe like the size of your pinky nail or smaller. But we don't know if there's even smaller particles that hasn't yet been tested. And we just don't know what effect it might be having on the animals that live there. Well, the only way to get out to this really isolated location is by ship. And it's really in the middle of nowhere. Between Hawaii and the United States, there's just a big swath of ocean with nothing in it, but it's actually a really cool ecosystem, very old with very unique and interesting animals that live there. But to be able to get out there, we have this research vessel, which gives us the capability to take careful measurements of the physical oceanography, so the temperature of the water and the physical characteristics of how it's moving, as well as actually looking at the plastic and the animals themselves. Well, we don't think we can sample the entire ocean in one single three-week cruise. But we're just hoping to just basically to continue to further the scientific effort and to set the stage for future scientific efforts. Because the North Pacific Gyre, there's gyres in all the oceans. That's just a term for the big, slow whirlpools driven by the major trade winds and westerlies of the world. So there is a South Pacific Gyre, there's a North Atlantic Gyre, and we think there might be debris accumulating in all of them. So we're just trying to look at one corner of the problem, and we're hoping to just start and set the stage for future research. What we know is that, and this is based on the research from the Agulita Marine Research Foundation, who are the people who've been going out there the most, we know there's probably no giant island. Like, there's nothing that you can see. Most of the pieces are really small and are smaller than you can easily see as you're traveling around on a boat. But the main point that I want to make is that we're not going to be able to like walk on the trash. We're not going to probably be able to see the trash. We might not see anything with our eyes. And that's why the kinds of sampling that we'll be doing mostly involve pulling various kinds of equipment and nets through the ocean so it will gather these particles that we couldn't otherwise easily see.
Part of what we're trying to do on this cruise is contribute to the area that's not what's not known scientific, or we're trying to fill in some of those gaps. There's a lot that isn't known. We really don't know the size. We really don't know this, or if you like, the scope and the scale of the problem. I think one of the most important things that we hope to get a handle on this cruise and probably over the next few years is what the sources are. And it's clearly many sources, but that's really, if we can figure that out, then we start to get a handle on some ways that we might be able to mitigate the problem. So I'll be the faculty advisor, but it's important to emphasize that this is a student cruise from conception of the idea to execution all the way to loading the equipment and driving the equipment back from Oregon. It's a really nice opportunity for a couple of reasons. One, a group of students coalesced around this issue a couple of years ago based on a seminar that was given here, really made clear the extent to which there's a scientific gap or it would be useful to get new scientific information. And the group really self-organized then through the vehicle of the UC SHIP funds application, put in an application with advisement or advising, but really, really motivated and bringing in, because it's a group of, it's a sort of a core group of 8 graduate students and then some associates as well, bringing in their own interests, their own expertises, and designing individual projects that can all be carried out.